A big hello to my English language viewers. Hello everyone, welcome to StudyIQ. In this video, I will bring to you December 1st week part 1, current affairs in English language. The questions are rather straightforward, do not require much explanation for this week. I have covered around 120 questions. Now, important thing to note here is that the first week of December, I have divided into three parts. This is only part 1, part 2 will be tomorrow and part 3 day after. We will run our sale from 10th December onwards. So from 10th December to I think around 15th December, we will run our first sale of December, then on Christmas and then on New Year. So if you want to buy any of the courses for SSC, Bank PO, UPSC, now we have launched individual courses for UPSC, like for GS, History, Geography, you know, Science and Technology, Environment and Ecology. We also have test series. So if you want to check out any of the course, just go to our website studyiq.com. Which company has become the first Chinese technology company ever to be valued at more than $500 billion. This company is Tencent. It's a Chinese company and it's a the president is Martin Lau. Alibaba is also a Chinese company. Its president is Jack Ma. He's the founder of Alibaba. It's just like Flipkart's e-commerce company. Now remember, there is another Chinese company called Oppo. Oppo has become the sponsor for the Indian cricket team and Vivo has become the sponsor for IPL. Then Xiaomi is another Chinese mobile company which has become the sponsor of two IPL teams, Kolkata Knight Riders and Royal Challengers Bengaluru. Who has been appointed as the first ever female ambassador of the United Kingdom to the United Nations? Her name is Karen Pierce. And remember, Sarah Clark, she is the first female black rod in the 650 years of the history. So Sarah Clark is the first female black rod and Karen Pierce is the first ever female ambassador of the UK to the UN. UK's Prime Minister is Theresa May. UN headquarters is in New York. India recently conducted a tri-service military exercise called DANX. At which place? It was conducted at Andaman and Nicobar Islands. Andaman Nicobar Island, the capital is Port Blair. It is present in the Bay of Bengal. And remember that Andaman Nicobar have two important volcanoes. One is called Narkondam. And the second one is called Barren Island. Which company has bought a stake in Urja Money and it will use for proprietary credit made technology? So basically this is a question from acquisitions. This company is Paytm. Founder is Vijay Shekhar Sharma and Paytm Payment Bank founder is Renu Sati. Not founder, exactly managing director you can say. And Paytm is owned by 197 Communications Company. E. Chandrasekharan Nair, he passed away. He was a famous what? So he was a politician. He was a politician from Communist Party of India, Kerala, CPI. So the answer is politician. Which state has won the gold medal for the best state pavilion at the 37th India International Trade Fair that was held in New Delhi? Before I tell you the answer to this question, there are three important questions that can be asked. India International Trade Fair is basically a place where all the states and countries, they put their pavilion, they showcase their good things. And this time the partner country was Vietnam. Number one question. Partner country, Vietnam. Focus country was Kazakhstan. Okay. Partner state was Jharkhand. These three questions can be asked. And then this question will be asked. Which state had the best pavilion? The answer is Assam. Assam beat Kerala. Kerala was second. And the ministry which had the best pavilion was Ministry for Water Resources, headed by Nitin Gadkari. He is the Minister for Water Resources, Ganga Rejuvenation and River Development. Also the Minister for Road Transport. Best international pavilion was Turkey. Turkey's capital is Ankara and president is Recep Erdogan. And the best central government enterprise was Post Nuclear Power Corporation of India. Which state has announced to celebrate Lachit Divas to promote the ideas and ideals of Lachit Borphukan? Who was Lachit Borphukan? He was a commander in the Ahom Kingdom, if you remember, in the 1671 war, Battle of Saraighat. So the answer is Assam. Assam, there is a dance also called Bihu. International Multilateral Maritime Search and Rescue Exercise 2017, which is called IMSAREX 2017. It recently began under the aegis of Indian Ocean Naval Symposium at which place? So it began in Bangladesh. Sheikh Hasina is the Prime Minister. Dhaka is the capital and Taka is the currency of Bangladesh. Now, they can also ask you which Indian ships they participated in this exercise. Our Chief of Navy is Sunil Lamba and the four Indian ships are INS Ranveer. Then there is a ship called INS Sayadri. By the way, Sayadri is also the name for Western Ghats. It is another name. Then there is INS Ghadiyal. Ghadiyal, by the way, is also the name of one type of crocodile found in the river Ganges, Ken, Betwa, etc. And there is a ship called Sukanya. So the four ships are Ranveer, Sayadri, Ghadiyal and Sukanya. How much amount has the central government sanctioned for establishing in Jaipur a anti-terrorism center called Global Center for Security and Counter-Terrorism? It will be set up at a cost of 275 crore rupees, and out of that 165 crore will be given by central government and the remaining 110 crore will be given by the government of Rajasthan. Which of the following payment gateway has launched Coinom? Coinom is India's first cryptocurrency exchange. It is launched by a company called Bildesk. Who has bagged the Sportsman of the Year award? Sportsman and Sportswoman of the Year were different awards in the individual sport category, which is not played by a team. So badminton, everybody knows, is played by an individual. And Sportswoman of the Year is PV Sindhu. Sportsman of the Year is, again, badminton player Kidambi Srikanth. And Pulela Gopichand is the coach for both Kidambi Srikanth and PV Sindhu. Now, there are other awards also that you need to remember. When it comes to team sports, so both the awards were bagged by cricketers. Sportsman of the Year is Ravichandra Ashwin, who recently completed 300 wickets in test matches. Sportswoman of the Year is the highest ever run getter in one day matches, and captain of Indian cricket female team Mithali Raj. Coach of the Year is Vishweshwar Nandi. Now remember, Vishweshwar Nandi is the coach of Deepa Karmakar. Deepa Karmakar is a renowned gymnast. She finished 4th in the Rio de Janeiro Olympics, narrowly missed by some points. Emerging sportswoman is Aditi Ashok. She plays golf. Emerging sportsman is Neeraj Chopra. He throws javelin. Inspiration honor went to Sania Mirza, who was a tennis player. Transformational contribution to sport award went to Abhinav Bindra, and rightly so. He is also heading TOPS scheme to bring some medals in the 2020 Tokyo Olympics. And Abhinav Bindra, he won the gold medal in the 2008 Beijing Olympics in the shooting. And team of the year is Indian women's cricket team, who performed exceptionally well, only missing out narrowly to England in the World Cup. DBS Bank, it is basically a Singapore bank. DBS Bank has lowered India's GDP growth forecast and current fiscal from 6.8% to what? So they have reduced it from 6.8% to 6.6%. But all is not bad news for India, because Moody's, they have upgraded India's rating from BAA3 to BAA2, and they have changed the outlook from stable to positive. Which institute has been ranked 29th in the world in terms of in the Times Higher Education ranking in the Global Employability Ranking? So this institute is Indian Institute of Science Bangalore, and it is ranked at 29th place in the world. By the way, there were two more institutes which made it to the top 150. IIT Delhi is ranked at 145, and IIT Bombay, it is ranked at 148. Which of the following countries, they conducted the joint air force exercise called Vigilante Ace? It was conducted by South Korea and United States. Basically, they are keeping an eye on North Korea, because it can launch ICBM anytime. Although reports are there that intercontinental ballistic missile is still not in possession with the North Koreans. Now, South Korea's capital is Seoul, and Hyundai, LG, Samsung, well, these are some companies from South Korea. And North Korea's currency is won, and Pyongyang is the capital. So that's all you need to know. And South Korea's president is Moon Jae-in. Our Ministry of Health and Family Welfare, in association with DHR and Indian Council of Medical Research, they have launched an initiative for the management of what? They want to manage high BP. High blood pressure is called hypertension. And this lady is Soumya Swaminathan. She is the Deputy Director General in the World Health Organization. Now remember, World Health Organization has kept a target to eliminate malaria from the world by 2030. But India is saying we will eliminate malaria by 2027. So it is 3 years before WHO deadline. Also, India wants to eliminate tuberculosis by 2025. How many medals has India won at the World Badminton Federation Para Badminton World Championship? Now, my first question for you today. Where is the headquarter of BWF, World Badminton Federation? Where is the headquarter? Can you write in comments? Para Badminton is for the disabled athlete, also called the differently abled athlete, the Divyang athletes. And India won 10 medals. 12th meeting of the Standing Committee of the Interstate Council was held where? Now, Interstate Council has been formed by the central government to resolve the disputes between various states on various issues, and the 12th meeting took place in the capital, New Delhi. Pradhan Mantri Sahaj Bijli Har Ghar Yojana, which means electricity at every home, it is called Sobhagya scheme in short. It has recently been launched in which state? It has recently been launched in the beautiful city of state of Manipur. Capital is Imphal. And Maricom is from Manipur, so is Irom Sharmila, and it has Loktak Lake. Which Indian bowler has broken 36-year-old record of the great Australian fast bowler Dennis Lilly to become the fastest bowler to reach 300 test wicket? Fastest bowler here means what? Ravichandra Ashwin is a spinner, right? Dennis Lilly took 300 test wickets in 56 test matches, but Ravichandra Ashwin has done it only in 54 matches. So absolute legendary player. Ravichandra Ashwin also awarded the sportsman of the year in the team category. So remember that. And there is a very difficult question that can be asked. Who was his 300th test victim? He took the wicket of a player. His name is Lahiru Gamaje. Lahiru Gamaje. Now my second question for you today. Which team is Lahiru Gamaje from? Which team does he play for? National Pharmaceutical Pricing Authority, it has announced to have capped the prices of how many essential medicines? The essential medicines total are 51 of whose the National Pharmaceutical Pricing Authority has announced price cap, which means you can't charge more than that. And NPPA chairman is Bhupender Singh. Which bank has recently launched Smart Banking 24/7 electronic lobbies in the Mumbai branch? You can see the smart machines here. You can simply go there and enjoy smart banking. This bank is Kotak Mahindra Bank and its chairman is Uday Kotak. Asian Development Bank, which is headquartered in Manila in Philippines, it has announced to provide a loan of how much amount to India to improve the road connectivity in 5 Indian states. Now, which are these 5 Indian states in which the roads will be built? In fact, more than 12,000 km roads will be built by National Highway Authority of India in Assam, Madhya Pradesh, Chhattisgarh, Odisha and West Bengal. These are the 5 states. Asian Development Bank president is Takehiko Nakao and the money that they are giving to India is $500 million. Which city recently elected its first woman mayor, Sukanya Bhati, Sanyukta Bhatia? Sanyukta Bhatia, by the way, is from Bharatiya Janata Party. Now in 100 years, she is the first woman mayor from Lucknow, the capital of Uttar Pradesh, Lucknow. Pradhan Mantri Narendra Modi, he recently inaugurated the metro rail project in which city? Which city will have a metro? It is Hyderabad. And this gentleman is Chandrasekhar Rao. He is the chief minister of Telangana. Telangana's capital is Hyderabad. Andhra Pradesh new capital is Amravati. And this gentleman here, you can see. Now, remember that metro, it does not come under Ministry of Railways. It comes under Ministry of Urban Development. Ministry of Urban Development, and he is the Minister for Urban Development. Housing and Urban Development have been merged into one department now, and his name is Hardeep Puri. Om Prakash Saraf, he passed away. He was a journalist and politician from which party or from which state? So he was a politician from Jammu and Kashmir. And he had become the first person in Jammu Kashmir to donate his body during his lifetime, you know, when he was alive, to the medical college. So he founded a party called Praja Socialist Party, PSP. PSP. Which union minister has started a digital signature campaign pledging to abide by the constitution? So this is basically to spread awareness about the ethos of the constitution that keeps India into one coherent unit. And this was done by our HRD minister, Prakash Javadekar, Human Resource Development Minister. Who has received the first lifetime achievement award from the Chandigarh Literary Festival? By the way, an important question is, which was the partner country in Chandigarh Literary Festival? It was Canada. So, who got the Lifetime Achievement Award? The great, great Ruskin Bond. Now, remember, Ruskin Bond's autobiography is called Lone Fox Dancing. Lone Fox Dancing. With which country did India recently sign an air services agreement? Our civil aviation minister is Ashok Gajapati Raju. And this was signed with Greece. Greece capital is Athens. Athens, by the way, hosted the first ever Olympics in 1896 and then again in 2004. And in Athens Olympics, it was Rajyavardhan Singh Rathore who had won the silver medal in double trap shooting. Rajyavardhan Singh Rathore right now is our sports minister. Who won the silver medal at the under 23 World Wrestling Championship that was held in Poland? Poland's capital is Warsaw. So there are two people, Bajrang Punia and Vinod Kumar. And also among the women, Ritu Fogart. She won the silver medal. Now, Ritu Fogart is daughter of Mahavir Fogart, on whose life Dangal movie was made. What is the name of the initiative that has been launched by the US-India Business Council, USIBC, to support women entrepreneurs? In fact, USIBC chairman is also a female. Her name is Nisha Biswal. And this initiative is called WISE. The full form of WISE is Women for Women Innovators, Social Leaders and Entrepreneurs. World Bank has agreed to provide which state government a subsidy of 7 lakh rupees per bus to buy 130 electric buses. So basically this is to spread awareness about climate change. If you buy one electric bus, 7 lakh out of that will be subsidized by the World Bank. This has been done in West Bengal. In fact, West Bengal is planning to run electric buses in 3 cities, Durgapur, Asansol and Kolkata. Which of the following organizations has started or formulated clinical guidelines on responding to children and adolescents who have been the victims of sexual abuse. This organization is World Health Organization, headed by Tedros Adhanom of Ethiopia, headquartered in Geneva. 140 ultra-luxury apartments project, which is called Trump Tower. It has been launched where? Now remember, this is the third tower of Donald Trump enterprise, and it was recently inaugurated in Kolkata. Which currency completed 100 years on November the 30th? This currency was launched on 30th November 1917. And when it was launched, it had the photo of King George V. And this is the only note in India that is signed by Finance Secretary and not the Governor of the Reserve Bank of India. It is 1 rupee note. Who won the gold medal in the World Championship weightlifting competition in Anaheim, California, ending India's 22-year-long wait? Why 22 years? Because before that, in 1995, Karnam Malleshwari, she had won the gold medal. And after 22 years, it has been won by Mirabai Chanu. Mirabai Chanu. My third question for you today. Mirabai Chanu is from which state? Write down in comments. By the way, Karnam Malleshwari also made India proud by winning in 2000 Sydney Olympics a bronze medal. Who has won the Best Actor Award in the International Bosphorus Film Festival in Turkey? What is his name? His name is Ishan Khattar. And the film is Beyond the Clouds. Remember, Beyond the Clouds, Mr. Majid Majidi is the director of this movie. Remember, this is a very, very important movie, Beyond the Clouds. Who has been appointed as India's G20 Sherpa till December 31st, 2018 for the development track? Now remember, in G20, there are two tracks. Okay, one is called the finance track. Finance track is managed by the department, by the Economic Affairs Secretary. He's the secretary in the Economic Affairs Department, whoever manages the financial track. But the development track is managed by a Sherpa, and Sherpa now is Shaktikant Das. Who has been conferred with the third Indian Council Award for Cultural Relations Distinguished Indologist Award by President Ramnath Kovind, who is the 14th President of India. His name is Hiroshi Marui and he is from Japan. Yen is the currency of Japan. Tokyo is the capital. Shinzo Abe is the Prime Minister. Demi Lechner-Peters, she has won the Miss Universe. And Miss World is Indian, Manushi Chiller. But Miss Universe is from which country? Her name is Demi Lechner-Peters. She is from South Africa. Who inaugurated the International Ambedkar Conclave that was organized by the Forum of Scheduled Caste and Scheduled Tribe Legislators and Parliamentarians in New Delhi? It was inaugurated by a person no less than the President of India, Ramnath Kovind. Now remember, Jual Oram is the Tribal Affair Minister and he is a Lok Sabha MP from Sundargarh in Odisha. Mukhtar Abbas Naqvi is Minority Affair Minister. Venkaiah Naidu is the Honorary 13th Vice President of India. Energy Efficiency Services Limited, EESL, it has recently organized Inspire 2017. It is an international symposium to promote innovation and research in energy efficiency in cooperation with the World Bank and AEEE. Now where was it held? It was held in the Pink City, Jaipur, and AEEE stands for Alliance Fund for an Energy Efficient Economy. What is the name of the first artificial intelligence politician that is developed by the scientist in New Zealand? New Zealand's Prime Minister is Jacinda Ardern. Very, very important. Jacinda Ardern is only 37 years old, and New Zealand's capital is Wellington, and Jacinda Ardern is the third woman Prime Minister in the history of New Zealand. And this artificial intelligence politician name is Sam. Which company has launched the first ever micro insurance plan, which is called Insurance Khata? Insurance Khata has been launched by India First Life Insurance. Who has been appointed the DGP of Andhra Pradesh? Andhra Pradesh dances Kuchipudi. Chandrababu Naidu is the CM from the Telugu Desam Party. His name is Mr. N. Sambiswar Rao. Who has been appointed as the new chairman and managing director of Air India? Now remember, Ashwani Lohani was there, he was replaced by Rajiv Bansal, and now Rajiv Bansal is replaced by Pardeep Singh Kharola. This is extremely important question because Ashwani Lohani was made the chairman of the Railway Board of India. Which country has recently announced that India has become the biggest market for its agricultural products in 2017? It was announced by Ukraine. We are buying pulses etc. from Russia and its neighbors. Ukraine's capital is Kiev and currency is Hryvnia. Who won the men's single title at the 2017 ITTF Challenge Spanish Open Table Tennis Championship that was held in Almira? So who won it? It was won by Mr. G. Satyan. Now my fourth question for you today. Where is this Almira? This city Almira is in which country? Can you write in comments? Justice Ved Prakash Vaish, he recently took oath as judge to which High Court? And Chief Justice of this High Court is D.B. Bhosal. I am talking about the Allahabad High Court. Allahabad High Court recently gave the judgment in the Arushi Talwar murder case. Which of the following authorities has recently granted the regulatory approval to a company called JM Financial? This can now launch a housing financial subsidiary. It is the NHB. Which state has made Telugu a compulsory subject from first standard to intermediate? It is Telangana. The answer could have been only Telangana and Andhra, because only in these two states Telugu is spoken. Now, Telangana recently gave Urdu language as the second official language status. Constitution Day or Samvidhan Divas is observed on November 26 every year to commemorate the adoption of the Indian Constitution. In which year was the Constitution adopted? Now remember, it was adopted on 26 November 1949. So the answer is 1949. But it came into effect 2 months later, exactly on 26 January 1950. And the chairman of the drafting committee was Dr. B.R. Ambedkar. Which company has commissioned India's first solar carport? This has been, commissioned on the roof of the Unity One Mall in New Delhi. This has been done by Tata Power Solar. And our target is 175 gigawatt by 2022 for the renewable energy in India. The Minister for Renewable Energy is Mr. R.K. Singh. Uttar Pradesh government has announced to organize Ayodhya Festival or Ayodhya Mahotsav in which country from next year? This country is South Korea. President Ramnath Kovind inaugurated the International Gita Mahotsav, Gita Festival, at which place? It was at Kurukshetra, the famous place where the Battle of Mahabharata was fought in Haryana. So the answer is Kurukshetra. Who has won the Individual Activist Award, Nelson Mandela Graca Machiel Innovation Awards for 2017? This award is given to a person from Egypt. What is his name? His name is Mr. Khalid Al-Balshi. And Egypt's capital is Cairo. There is a river called Nile. There are great pyramids in Egypt. There is a Tahrir Square in Egypt. IKEA, it's a furniture company. It has opened its first experimental center, IKEA Hedge Home, at which place? This they have launched at Hyderabad. And remember, IKEA is a company originally from Sweden. And there is another company from Sweden which is called Volvo. Who chaired the first meeting that was held recently regarding how we can transform 115 backward districts of India by 2022? This was done by Cabinet Secretary P.K. Sinha. Pandit Narayan Rao Bodas passed away. He was associated with which thing? So he was basically a musician. He was a classical singer. Who has received the European Golden Boot for the fourth time? This is given to a person who scores the maximum number of goals in Europe in a one single season. Now, he has tied up with Cristiano Ronaldo, who has also four Golden Boots. Messi is the answer. He plays for Argentina and also for Barcelona Football Club. Who has become the first Indian American to gaggle with the press? Gaggle with the press means talk to the press as a press briefing about the presidential plane Air Force One by Donald Trump. So his name is Raj Shah. There was a tripartite agreement. Tripartite means three parties are involved. So it was signed by National Skill Development Corporation, THSC. What is THSC? It means Tourism and Hospitality Sector Skill Council. With which company? To provide hospitality skill training to hospitality micro entrepreneurs in India. This was done by a company called Airbnb. And remember, there is a company called Facebook. Now, Facebook started a program called She Means Business. She Means Business. Which company has announced to launch a multi-level challenge called Startup C-Cube in collaboration with HAX and Kickstarter? This company is Amazon India, and Amazon's founder is Jeff Bezos. A new species of gecko, which is called Mahendragiri gecko, has been found where? Now, the scientific name is interesting. Now, pay attention. Hemidactylus Sushil Dattai. This is the scientific name that has been kept to honor Sushil Datta. And who is Sushil Datta? He is a renowned herpetologist. Herpetologist is a scientist who studies reptiles. So where was it found? It was found in Andhra Pradesh. Photographer Shakro Khatami passed away. He is a famous photographer who risked his life to cover Iranian revolution also. Where was he from? He was from Iran itself. And Iran, we are building Chabar port. Iran's president is Hassan Rouhani. Afghanistan's president is Ashraf Ghani. Don't confuse the two. Which of the following is world's first Sanskrit 3D movie? It was recently screened at the International Film Festival of India in Panaji, Goa. This film is called Anurakthi. And it basically revolves around the traditional art form of Kerala, which is called Koodiyattam. It is the art of Kerala on which the movie is made. Which country has recently conducted a marine oil pollution response exercise called Clean Sea 2017? This is basically to tackle the problems like oil spill and other problems which pollute our oceans. And this was done by India. It was conducted in Port Blair in Andaman Nicobar. How much amount is India going to provide Afghanistan to help strengthen their public transport system of the capital Kabul. India is providing a help of 2.87 million USD. Ashraf Ghani is the president, Kabul is the capital. The 7th edition of the International Military Sports Council, where the militaries of all the countries participate and play games, compete in the games, it is being held in Wuhan in China. And what is the theme? The theme is Military Glory, World Peace. Military Glory, World Peace. Now remember important thing, what is the mascot? Mascot is Bing Bing. And Bing Bing is a Chinese fish. Similarly, the mascot for FIFA Under 17 Football World Cup was Kheleo, it is a clouded leopard. And for Asian Athletic Championship was Oli. And for the Youth Boxing Championship that took place recently in Guwahati, it was Guppy. UN Environment. It has announced to provide how much amount to the developing countries of the world to continue their work in eliminating or phasing out ozone depleting chemicals. As per the Montreal Protocol provisions, this amount is $540 million. Which airline has partnered with Air France KLM to boost the connectivity in Europe? The chairman of this airline is Naresh Goyal. It is Jet Airways. Standard & Poor. It has retained India's sovereign rating with a stable outlook at what? It is BBB-. Who has won the men's IBSF World Snooker Championship that was held in Doha, capital of Qatar? Qatar will host the 2022 FIFA Football World Cup. His name is Pankaj Advani. He's from Karnataka. International Day of Solidarity with those who are from Palestine. That is the Palestinian people. It was recently observed when? So it was observed on November the 29th. Also in 2017, we completed 50 years of the Arab-Israeli War of 1967. Southall Football Club. It is going to jointly set up an international level football academy with Kordia Institute at Sanghol, at which place? This will be done at Punjab. Captain Raminder Singh is the CM. Which bank has partnered with the Boston Consulting Group BSG company for its transformational initiatives? This bank is Karnataka Bank. Also, they have launched something known as KBL Vikas. This is the newest project of Karnataka Bank. And managing director and CEO of this bank is Mr. Mahabaleshwar MS. There was a two-day Korea festival. It was recently held where? It was held in Gurugram. Gurugram is the new name of Gurgaon in Haryana. Also remember, there is a Amin village which has been renamed to Abhimanyupur after the son of Arjuna in Mahabharata called Abhimanyu. India will sign an agreement for cooperation in policy planning, technology transfer and institutional organization in the urban transport sector with which country? This we will do with UK. Who has been appointed as the president of the 36th International Geological Congress that will take place in India in Delhi in 2020? His name is Vijay Prasad Dimri. For the first time, Bitcoin's price has crossed what mark? It is appreciated by more than 900%. It touched $10,000. Who has been appointed as the president of Institute for Defense Studies and Analysis called IDSA? Her name is in fact Nirmala Sitharaman. We are talking about defense and she is the first full-time defense minister of India. Which state recently conducted a media interaction program with Myanmar? It was conducted by Manipur. In fact, it was held in the capital, Imphal. Myanmar's foreign minister is Aung San Suu Kyi. President is Hatin Kayao. And Myanmar's capital is Naypyidaw. President Ramnath Kovind recently inaugurated the conference on National Law Day, organized by Niti Aayog and Law Commission of India. National Law Day, National Constitution Day, both are celebrated on 29th November. The Constitution Day is also called National Law Day. The theme was Structural Reforms for Overcoming Delays in Justice Delivery and Scope of Judicial Power, Judicial Activism. So it was celebrated in New Delhi. Which of the following sports authorities of India has been formally recognized as a national body by the Indian Olympic Association? Now, Indian Olympic Association Secretary General is Rajiv Mehta. And this is the Boxing Federation of India, BFI. Now, remember, Boxing Federation of India President is Ajay Singh. Who has won the men's national skeet gold at the 61st National Shotgun Championship that was held in New Delhi? His name is Mairaj Ahmed Khan. Mairaj Ahmed Khan. Who was honored with the Indian Film Personality 2017 Award at the 48th International Film Festival of India that was held in Goa? So his name is Amitabh Bachchan. Now there are 6-7 questions that can be asked. The opening film was Beyond the Clouds. It is Majid Maijidi. Remember Ishan Khattar? So best film is 120 Beats per Minute. It's a French movie directed by Robin Campillo. Best female actor is Parvati Thiruvoth Kotuvatta for the movie Take Off. Best male actor is Nahual Perez Biscayard from 120 Beats per Minute movie. Best director is Vivian Koo from Angels Wear White movie. Lifetime Achievement Award is given to Atom Egoyan. And ICFT UNESCO Gandhi Medal went to Kshitij Horizon. Which state government has passed an order banning the use of firecracker during the winter season for 2 months? That is from December and January, basically, the firecrackers will be banned in 6 major cities. Which are the 6 cities? Raipur, Raigarh, Bilaspur, Durg, Bhilai and Korba. So I'm talking about Chhattisgarh. Central government has recently promulgated an ordinance to amend which of the following laws? It is the Insolvency and Bankruptcy Code of 2016. Insolvency and Bankruptcy, IBBI, the president is MS Sahu, who has been elected as the new foreign academician at the Chinese Academy of Sciences. His name is Bill Gates. He is the one of the founders of Microsoft, who has been appointed as the first chairman of the National Anti-Profiteering Authority. Even in GST, we have a National Anti-Profiteering Clause. So his name is Badri Narayan Sharma, who has been appointed as the chairman of the 15th Finance Commission. This is very important. The chairman of the 14th Finance Commission is YB Reddy, who is the ex-governor of the Reserve Bank of India. And for 15th Finance Commission, the chairman is N.K. Singh. Now remember, Finance Commission gives the suggestions on what should be the revenue share between the center and the state for the taxes collected. External Affairs Minister Sushma Swaraj, she attended the annual Shanghai Cooperation Organization. In fact, India and Pakistan both became members in 2016. Where was this SCO summit held? So it was held in Sochi. Sochi is in Russia. Who has been appointed as the secretary in the Ministry of Water Resources? Water Resources headed by Nitin Gadkari, and the secretary is Mr. Upender Prasad Singh. Which state government has notified the rules for banning the goods carriage operators from forming cartels in the state? Because it is also a type of oligopolistic market, and in oligopolistic market, the cartels are very frequent. So there have to be anti-cartel mechanisms, and this is one. It is announced by the government of Punjab. Who has been appointed as the new Secretary General of the Lok Sabha? This is a very important question. Her name is Snehlata Srivastav, and she will replace Anup Mishra. Who has become the first Indian man to win the Asian Marathon Championship after winning the gold medal at the 16th edition of an event that was held in China at a place called Dongguan? His name is Mr. Gopi Thonakal. Which state government has introduced Fish Pond Yojana? So basically to promote aquaculture, fishy culture, piscy culture for freshwater aquaculture. This has been done by the government of Odisha. President Ramnath Kovind recently cleared an ordinance amending the Indian Forest Act of 1927, omitting which of the following grown in non-forest area from the definition of a tree. And since this tree is now no more categorized as a tree, it can be cut. So this will help industrialization, and this is bamboo. I also remember ordinance is promulgated only when the session is not in place. Who has become the first captain to score 10 international centuries in one calendar year? His name is Virat Kohli. He recently scored his 51st career 100 in international cricket. Indian government is going to offer technical support and advisory services to which country for setting up of digital locker services? This country is Mauritius. Capital is Port Louis. Who launched a training program for elected women representatives, EWR of Panchayati Raj Institution and Master Trainer? So this is Maneka Gandhi, and she is the Minister for Women and Child Development. Which of the following has become the first state in Australia to legalize the assisted dying, also called euthanasia, for the terminally ill? This is the Victoria state, and this they will do from 2019 onwards. Which of the following has been awarded as the most visited place in the world by World Book of Records? It is called Harminder Sahib. It is also called Golden Temple. It is in Amritsar. Which company has commissioned its first ATR simulator at the Central Training Establishment in capital of Telangana, Hyderabad? It is again Air India. Scientists from which country, they have said that between 445 and 485 million years gap, there was an increase in biodiversity. So this was because of increase in the level of oxygen. So scientists from which country, they have done this research? It is the scientists from Washington University in America. Scientists at which university, they have converted Escherichia coli bacteria, which is a commensal bacteria, into the world's smallest tape recorder? Which university has done it? It is the Columbia University. Which airline has recently received Category 3B certification from the Directorate General of Civil Aviation, allowing it to operate in dense foggy condition? It is Air India Express. Which country is going to assist India to set up a National Crisis Management Center? National Crisis Management Center will be assisted by Russia. And Kundankulam Nuclear Power Plant also with Russia help. Bhel also with Russia help. And BrahMos Missile also with Russia help. Which union minister has formally launched Paytm Payment Bank? Arun Jaitley has launched it, Paytm Payment Bank branch recently. And Paytm Payment Bank came after Airtel Payment Bank and India Post Payment Bank. It was the third payment bank to open in India. Who has been stripped of the Freedom of Oxford Award? Freedom of Oxford Award was given to Aung San Suu Kyi. It has been now been taken away from her.
because she has done very little to prevent the genocide of the Rohingya Muslims in Rakhine State in Myanmar. Which company has acquired Time Inc. for $2.8 billion? This is around 17,000 crore rupees. So this company is Meredith Corporation. Which men's and women's kabaddi team won the Asian Kabaddi Championship gold medal in Gurgaon in Iran? It men's and women both were won by India. India men's team beat Pakistan in the final, and Indian women's team beat South Korea in the final. Government has doubled the incentive under the merchandise export from India scheme MEIS to what? Earlier it was 2%, now it is 4%. Our Commerce Minister is Suresh Prabhu. Which insurance company has announced to have implemented electronic national automated clearinghouse called electronic NACH service of the National Payments Corporation of India? This is ICICI Prudential Life Insurance. Ministry of Housing and Urban Affairs. It has approved the construction of 1.12 lakh more affordable houses under Pradhan Mantri Awas Yojana Urban. It is also called Housing for All, Rural and Urban. Rural target is 4 crore houses, urban target is 2 crore houses, and the deadline is 2022. So the, what will be the investment for 1.12 lakh houses under the Pradhan Mantri Awas Yojana Urban? The investment will be 8105 crore rupees. Famous lyricist and singer John Hendricks passed away. He was associated with which music genre? He was associated with jazz. Which bank has launched an instant international payment service using the Ripple's enterprise blockchain technology solution?
Axis Bank.
This bank is Shikha Sharma is the managing director. Who has been appointed as the managing director and CEO of Aegon Life Insurance? His name is Vineet Arora. This is a direct question. David Cassidy passed away. He was a famous what? So he was a singer from United States of America. Who headed the committee? Now there was a subcommittee of the Financial Stability and Development Council FSDC which reviewed the major developments that could impinge on India's financial stability. So which committee gave comment on the India's financial stability? This is the Urjit Patel committee headed by the governor of RBI. Which country has signed an agreement with Myanmar for repatriation of Rohingya to their homes in the Rakhine state? Because 6 lakh Rohingyas are in this country. It is Bangladesh, and 40,000 Rohingyas are in India. Which state chief minister recently launched the official logo, mascot and countdown for the Hockey Men's World Cup 2018 that will take place in Bhubaneswar? It is Odisha. It has Bhitarkanika National Park and Gahirmath Beach. Which bank has launched digital supply chain finance solution? It is launched by Bank of Baroda headed in Vadodara in Gujarat. Todapuzi Vasanti passed away. He was a famous what? So he, actually it is she. She was an actress from Malayalam film industry. She has acted in more than 440 films. Which Formula One driver won the Abu Dhabi Grand Prix? Abu Dhabi is the capital of United Arab Emirates. It is won by Valtteri Bottas. He drives Mercedes. He's a teammate of Lewis Hamilton, the world champion. So this was the part 1 of week 1. Part 2 I will bring tomorrow morning in English language. Keep supporting me by sharing the videos with all of your friends. Thank you so much.